Good morning students, welcome to e-learning. Today we are going to start with an overview of our chapter 3, that is demand. As many of the students has asked to make me an overview for chapter 3, as it is a big chapter as well as it is an important chapter. So quickly start with this overview where I'm be covering some important points for the topic, as well as I will be discussing you about what are the questions will be coming up and how you have to write the answers. And for some of the questions you no need to write one or two line explanation, you need to go with further more explanation. So quickly start with this particular topic. So here is a chapter 3 demand and overview. So as we have seen the meaning of demand, we already know that is it is a quantity of a commodity which a buyer desire, is able and willing to buy at a given price at the given point of time. And you find that it has of namely five factors. That is, five factors is about the meaning I'm telling. Okay, the determinants of demand, it is not the determinants of demand. Many of you have written it is a determinants of demand. No, it is a, we can say it is a points. That is, it one should have desire, second it should have willingness to buy, third it should have ability to buy, fourth we can say at a particular point of price and at a particular point of time. So all these five factors should be are the key points in your meaning of demand. So that's why I have written it is consist of five factors, but it is not a factors of demand or factors affecting demand. Okay, it's just about the meaning, clear? But whenever it asks factors affecting demand, you have to go with this particular thing, that is price of a commodity. There are two things, price of a commodity or service, and second is factors other than price. So one is the price which is affecting the demand, and second is the other than price, like we can say taste and preference, income of a consumer, price related goods. Then after you find that expectations about future prices, and lastly the size and demographic profile of the population. So you find that nearly 6 points which are be there. Again, if you see the price of related goods consists of two things, that is supplementary goods and complementary goods. Again, we have seen all this particular thing in detail, but I am not going to discuss much about. We know that how price affects. We know that if the price increases, the demand, sorry, price decreases, the demand increases. So we see that whenever a commodity is, the price is reduced, there is an increase in demand, or we can say oppositely, whenever there is a demand for any product, you find that there is a, ultimately there is a change in its price, that is decrease in the price. Again, you find that here when price increases, your demand decreases. Then after other determinants, that is taste and preference. Yes, this particular factor other than price means there are the consumers which are there, that is individual or consumer which are consuming goods, their taste and preference differs. It is from individual to individual, it is differs. And you find that here there is a different age wise or different, we can say trending fashion wise, there is a change in their demand for any product. So it changes the demand for the product as per the time and the tradition, or we can say fashion which is going. Second is the income. With a different class of people, you find that there is a demand for the goods also increases as decreases. Again, you find that if a person was earning good amount and now he is earning less amount due to this particular pandemic situation, his demand for some of the goods will become, we can say, lesser. Whereas you find that demand for sanitizer and mask, which has been there, it's become a mandatory purpose in this pandemic situation, it becomes. So here it, we find that as per the income also, we find that there is a reduction in his consumption of some of the other goods which we were been doing earlier. Now we are not purchasing some of the things which are been there. We are cooking food at home and only, and you are eating that particular food, cooked food at home only, not the outside food which are been there. Again, then after price of related goods, substitute goods, we have seen what are there. You find that suppose you don't get, I told you about like Coca-Cola, you can go with Pepsi or thumbs up. So you find that that is a particular thing where you find that you can replace your concern good, or we can say main good, with your same identical other brand good. So this is what is happening up, and it affects the particular thing that suppose your main product price rises, you automatically shift to the identical product. Or suppose your identical product prices are reduced, what is happening, you again shift from main good to another good. So both of the way you find that there is a shifting of the demand which has been fine. Again, then comes the price of complementary goods. Here complementary goods, remember it is a jointly products or joint goods which are been there, where you find that those can be consumed jointly. Means suppose aapko car chalana hai, so you have to fill up your petrol. So this is what is there, you find it. If you want to sit in the AC, under the AC, you find that you have to automatically, you find that you have to switch on the switch, and then after you have to use AC. So ultimately it consumes electricity. So this is what is happening. You find that they are complementary goods. So demand for AC is there, so it again require a demand for electricity. Same way, if there is, you want to travel with your car, if you want to go in car, so what is happening? You have to fill up the fuel, that is maybe petrol or diesel. So there is a requirement of fuel, then only the car will go. So ultimately this particular thing is going on and this is happening. Then comes, we find that expectations regarding future prices. Now what is that? You find that suppose you think that in future this particular prices are going to rise, that particular product price is going to rise. So ultimately what will happen? The consumer will purchase at present with a more price. For example, gold. As the price of gold is going higher and higher, you find that people, those who are having money, not we, but those who are having rich class people, they are purchasing, they are investing the money in that particular thing. Again, same way with some of the products, not luxurious, but we can say nominal products. If we find that in future, like we find our vegetable oils are there. So if fortune oil, so fortune sunflower oil is there, or peanut oil is there, if that particular prices are going to rise in the next 1 or 2 months, you find that your mother will purchase at present when the prices are, whatever is the price. So this is what is happening up. Clear? Then of the size and demographic profile of the population, it talks about your what we can say, behavior, habit, your stay area, everything, locality, everything. So you find that if you are living in India and living in suppose northern side, they try to eat, consume more of chapatis and sabjis, where if you go with south, you find that they are consuming more of rice and we can say sabjis. So this is what, depending on the locality also, population also, their cultural tradition, the what is the requirement, what is the basic needs of that particular thing is been also dependent. So this is what is happening up here, where it also affects the market. Like suppose in India there is a majority is the youth, so any product which has been long, for example Realme, Redmi, OnePlus, all these particular mobiles are made for games and every different purpose, with different selfie cameras and so many different megapixel phone or different features are there in the mobile phone. So what is happening up? So they are targeting the youth of the Indian people with you, they are giving with the maximum thing with the minimum amount under the mobile phone itself. So this is what is happening up, which we are looking and we are finding every now and there. So that is also there. So this also is coming under that particular thing. Then comes the demand function. Now remember one point, as I have asked this particular question in your monthly examination, or we can say after this particular examination we have taken test. So in suppose this demand function is been asked for 1 mark, you have to explain this meaning only. But suppose it has been asked for 2 marks, you have to write down the equation as well as all the, we can say, symbols, or we can say px equals to, we can say price of commodity x, py equals to price of related goods, expectation regarding future prices, that is pe, taste and preference, that is t, consumer's income, that is y. So all this particular thing though which you are seeing on this particular screen will be how to write for your 2 marks question. Suppose it is asked for only 1 mark, you have to write demand functions, those are mathematical functions, relation between demand for a good and determinants of its demand. So this is what is happening up. I hope you have been understood. So if this full is been asked for 2 marks, you have to explain it well in, and suppose it is asked for 1 mark, you have to explain only the meaning. Clear? Chalo. Next, coming to the law of demand, we know that you find that keeping all the other determinants constant, you find that Alfred Marshall says that if a price of a commodity falls or price of a good falls, its demand expands, and if price of a good rises, it demands contracts. So this is what the law of demand has been there, where there is an inverse relation between the price and demand of the particular good. So you find that again there are certain assumptions to apply this law of, we can say, demand. You have to go with particular assumptions. So there are 5 assumptions, that is, what are the determinants, that is, taste and preference of the consumer remains unchanged, or we can say same, or we can say constant. Then after, income of a consumer remains unchanged, that is same, constant. We can say price of substitute goods and complement, that is related goods, also remain same. Then after, you find that consumer do not make any anticipate regarding future prices. So you find that then after, the size of a population also does not change. So all these particular factors affecting demand, that is other than price, should not change. And then after, it is relating with the price. If a price change, the demand sorry, there is a change in demand also. So price increase, demand decrease, price decrease, demand increase. This is what. Then after comes the schedule. So what does the schedule means? If a demand schedule has been asked, you have in the meaning, you have to write down the meaning. That is a schedule showing willingness of a consumer to buy at different quantities. Means it shows different variations of combinations where you find that there is a price is been shown to them, as well as there is a different quantities is been shown with a different price tag. So this is what the meaning is all about, and you have to show with the example. If it is asked for 2 marks, if it is asked for 1 marks, you have to go with only the meaning, that is the 3 lines above. Then comes the demand curve. So it is a graphical representation of the demand schedule, or a schedule showing the demand of a good and a price of good, is called demand curve, which has been there. Then further you find that you have to plot and you have to analyze. I'm not going with analysis because we already know, we have already studied. If you still find any doubt, you can just call me personally and I will explain you about that particular thing, because it's an overview. Then comes what are the reasons for inverse relationship. So there are two reasons. First is the income effect. We know that as a consumer, suppose for example there is an individual, we can say your big brother is already there, he has completed his degree and he is now going for a job and he is working. So earlier when he was in the college time, he was not earning, so that time his income was zero, and you find that time he was not able to purchase from his own pocket, but now he is getting his income and he has his income, he has got his job and he is satisfying his needs. So ultimately when he gets an income, a person gets an income, he try to consume a different particular type of goods. Matlab koi bhi cheez purchase kare to uske andar wo demand to badhega. So ultimately when there is an income earner which is an increase, or we can say those who are income earners are already there is an increase in their salary or wages, you find that they try to consume more and more. So here it has been told that a consumer remains constant but the price of good falls, here the real income rises. Agar do cheez ho sakti yahan pe aisa bol raha hai ki agar consumer ka income kuch change nahi ho raha lekin price goods kam ho raha hai to wo zyada purchase karega. Yes, if a real income increases, matlab uska price, uska income, salary is increased, the consumer will buy more because to consume more, so he will demand more. Mostly normal goods have positive income effect. Normal goods kisko bolenge, the day to day life which we, the foods which you are eating, they have the positive effect, because ki jaise jaise income badhega waise waise uska bhi thoda thoda price badhega. So either inferior goods have negative effects. Same way, negative means if the income of that particular our consumer rises, what will happen? That particular product is not demanded. Whereas when your income rises, your normal goods demand will increase. So that is also been told here. Then after substitution effect, which is jo humne factors affecting determined mein padha hai. When we find that concerned goods fall, price of a concerned good falls, it becomes relatively cheaper than its substitutes. The consumer will reduce the consumption of substitute goods and expanded demand for the concerned good. Matlab yahan pe bola ki agar substitute product ki price kam ho jaye, Coca-Cola is your main product and we can say Pepsi is your substitute. Matlab आपका टेस्ट के हिसाब से पेप्सी इज अ सब्स्टिट्यूट प्रोडक्ट. नाउ देयर इज अ चेंज, देयर इज अ रिडक्शन इन योर पेप्सी पर्टिकुलर price. So what is happening? You try to shift from your main product, that is Coca-Cola, to Pepsi, because as it has become cheaper than the, see, this is what is happening. Or we can say your main product prices have reduced, so you will shift yourself from substitute goods to your concerned good. So this is what substitution effect affects. The, we can say, it shows the inverse relation between the demand and the price of a good. Now what are the things which are not, or where the law of demand is not applicable, that is exception to the law of demand? That you find that if a price of a good falls, the demand also falls, and if a price of a good increases, the demand also increases. First is prestigious goods. Prestigious goods means those who are, we can say, those goods which are consumed by the rich people. You have to write with the example for 1 marks also. That is, you have to write gold, silver, jewelries, luxurious car, mobile phone, etc. Then after extremely low price goods, then after given goods, special preference of people. So extremely, we are going to look in the details. So here you find that which are consumed by very high class of people, like we can say jewelry, expensive cars. Then after you find the extremely low price goods, that is which the price does not, like matchstick is there, your staple pins are there. So all these particular pins are there, maths books are there. Their prices are very nominal, and it has been, though it is nominal, we does not care for it particular any maths box or pins here. So it is also there. Then after you find that given goods, that is inferior quality of goods, where you find that laborers, mostly the construction laborers or the poor class of people, try to eat this particular goods, that is nothing but we can say given goods. Then after you find that special preference of the people, like they are some of the peoples are very much addicted to the brands, so that particular time you find that certain goods does not require any other any other types of good. They are only specifically go with some of the brands, like branded brand of shoes, we can say branded clothes or different branded watches. So they have their own addiction, or not addiction, but they have their own desire to have that particular good only. So that time you find that the demand of that particular any other good does not affect him, because he want that particular same brand goods only. So this is what is happening. Then after expansion and contraction, the main point of this chapter, where it also can be coming up in your examination, so you have to remember what is expansion and contraction. So see, there are two things: changes in demand, which has been seen. First is the expansion and contraction of demand. Second is increase and decrease. So you have to clear cut identify what is expansion and contraction of demand. So first we have to go with here, that is keeping the utter determinants constant, we find there is a change in the price, and due to change in price there is a change in demand curve. So when contraction and expansion of demand is been asked, you have to clear cut know that it is because of change in the product price, not due to change in other than price. So the price falls keeping other determinants constant, matlab jo bhi other determinants, taste and preference are there, you find that price of related goods are there, income of a consumer is there, demographic and size of population is there, expectation regarding future price is there, all these product prices all these factors are does not changing, they are remaining same, but only the price has been changed. So here you find that you have to remember the table, and you have to go this particular diagram, remember this, there is you have to go here, you find that there is a center point A, that is at price rupees 3 there is a demand for 3 units, and here is a A point. So suppose that is you have to start, this is the initial price. Suppose your price has increased, it goes price increase by means from 3 it goes to 5, what happens? There is a contraction of demand. Why? Because price bad gaya lekin hamara demand moved from right to left, that is it contract from unit 3 to 1. So as you see, when a price increases the demand falls, and there is now demanding 1 rupees, that is at point B. Same way again to start with the point A, now the price has decreased to rupees 1. So when it is decreased to 1, he is demanding now 5 units. So what is happening? 5 units is been asked here, and you find that there is an increase in demand. So you find it becomes 3 se badke 5 ho gaya, aur 5 hamara there is an increase in demand. So there is an expansion of demand which has been there. So here is a DD curve, and DD curve is the same. Here is a point A, and point B is the initial start. If a suppose price increases, it goes towards your left hand side at the point B, there is above the, we can say here at price of 5 rupees there is a demand for 1 unit, and same way you can say that is a contraction of demand, matlab ye upar ta ja raha hai lekin hamara demand 3 se leke 1 pe hai, that's why it is contraction. Same way again starting from A, and if the price decreases from rupees 3 to 5, matlab yahan pe 3 rupees hai wo 1 rupees ho gaya, now the demand has increased from 3 units to 5 units, so it call expansion of demand. So clear cut understand this particular logic, you will get identified. I'm not going to explain because I already explained in this particular video. Now increase and decrease of demand. Now this is another part of we find change in demand curve. Now what is happening up here? Some of the other factors other than price are changing, and because of that there are 5 points, or we can say supplementary and complementary goods. So there are 6 points are there. If any of them having change, matlab kisi income, the consumer ka income badh gaya, nahi to supplementary goods ka price kam ho gaya, ya we can say there is a change in the population, there is a change, there is a expectation like in future there is a fall in price or increase in price, so it all affect that particular demand of that particular product other than price. Okay, other than price may increase, decrease, and contraction expansion may price is a factor. So remember that. So what is happening up, you find that this particular type, the price is constant, so 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, but your demand is increase and decrease. So again, you have to start from rupees 3, the demand is 3, that is point A. Now, suppose price is not changing, but due to taste and preference, what happened that this particular product was olded ho gaya, it is became outdated. Now, what is happening? The demand has decreased to 1. So it will contract to the B, or that is the unit is 1, and you find that here at a point B there is a decrease in demand. See, the price is constant, that's why this DD curve is a straight, sorry, this not DD curve, there is a straight line which has been drawn, and on here you find that there is a demand curve, that is D1 which is bent. Now it has been shifted to this B point, that's why it become D2. This is a new one, new demand curve, where the demand has decreased from unit 3 to unit 1. Now again, starting from this point, again we have seen decrease in demand. I hope you have been clear. Now coming that again, in the price 3, there's a demand is 3. Now what happened? You find that here, again from here, what we can, there is an this particular became so much famous and popular, or we can say in future they have seen that this particular product prices are getting higher, that's why their public is purchasing at present. So it became, demand became 5, the same price. Now those people who are purchasing 3, now they are asking for 5 units. So from A point it is want with a point C. Now what is happening up, there is an increase and decrease. So here you find that there is an increase in demand and the price is constant. So you find this is what is happening up here. So it shows that there is only shift towards your right hand side and left hand side. So when the demand curve is moving to the left hand side, see here from A to B, you find that there is a decrease in demand, and when from the initial point A it is moving to your, we can say, right hand side, you find that A to C is a right hand side movement, and you find it is an increase in demand. Now this is because of price is constant and other factors other than price factors affects the demand of a product. I hope you are being clear with that. You have to write your analysis, you can just go with that, but you have already written in your notes. Now further, there is an individual demand and market demand. Now ye bahut simple concept, easy concept which you know ki why, suppose you are want to purchase a chocolate, 1 kg of mango. I give an example of mango, I think so. Yes, so you find that an individual want to purchase a 1 kg of mango, he has to go with the that particular point of time, how much is the price and how much is the demand, and on the basis of that he will purchase. But when there is a, your whole friend group or your whole society want to purchase that particular mango, and there the demand is more. So what is happening? So all the individual total, the sum of all the such individual demand of the existing consumer in the market is a, we can say, market demand at that particular given point of time and that particular given point of price. So this is what is happening up here. Only one person is demanding, that is individual demand. If all the together, sum of all the individual, a group of people is been demanding for a product, that is become market demand. So it is not very hard or difficult to understand, but it's very easy. So here we have seen this particular 3 things, that is demand of A, demand of B, and demand of 3, and we have bought according to their prices, and we have seen the demand curve which has been observed. So remember that there is a change here in this particular diagram. If you find minute, you can refer to your textbook where you find there is what exactly the change is been observed. Again, when you merge all that particular 3, you find that there is 1, 2 and 3, it becomes 6 total, 2, 3, 4, 9, 3, 4, 5, that is 12, 4, 5, 6, it is 15, 5, 6, 7, it is 18. Now the price is here the same and the demand is of 3 of them together. So you find that the demand curve shows like this particular thing. Ultimately the same concept, law of demand, applies everywhere, that the price increases, the demand decreases, but price falls, the demand increases, which has been there. Now to measure this all, we can say at what different prices, what can be happening up, that to measure that particular, what is a change, what type of change is occurring, either it is increasing the demand, it is decreasing the demand due to price and all that particular thing. To measure that, there is, we find that to identify, there is a method, that is, we can not method, we can say there is a system, that is price elasticity of demand. So price elasticity of demand shows the proportion to the demand changes with a change in its price. मतलब कितने price पे कितना demand change हो रहा है वो हम देख सकते हैं, और उसको देखने के लिए it can be expressed with this type of formula, that is change, proportionate change in demand upon proportionate change in price, and you find that this is what is happening up. again there is a definition which is given by the Alfred Marshall. Okay, then there are 5 degrees, that is, or we can say 5 degrees of price elasticity of demand. It is only about price elasticity. Income elasticity is different and cross elasticity is also different. Now we are moving to end topic only. So just quickly revise about the perfect elasticity. See, perfectly elastic demand, perfectly inelastic demand, unitary demand, relatively elastic demand, and relatively inelastic demand. Okay, here inelastic will come, inelastic demand. So you have to remember with this. If you remember this chart, you can able to draw in your examination. So you remember that this particular thing, the symbol which is there. So EP, that is elasticity of price, equals to infinite. Then after EP equals to 0, EP equals to 1, EP is greater than 1, EP is less than 1. So perfectly elastic, infinite. Perfectly inelastic, it is 0. Unitary, it is equal to 1. Relatively elastic, it is greater than 1. Relatively inelastic, it is less than 1. I have asked in MCQ also, but many of them have given wrong answers under this. Though there is a lastly, in the last long question, in that same test, they have explained well, but in the same thing in MCQ, you have not got your answer though. So you have to be active with, I can ask anything from the textbook inside also for your MCQ, either one or two, not all of them, but some one or two. So you have to have a presence of mind which has been there. So you find that your perfectly elastic looks like this. So you find that your demand is infinite. There is an infinite change in demand and there is no change in your price. So that's why you find that the price is constant and demand, which is here, it is not shown. So there is an infinite change in demand and there is a negligible change in its price. That is perfectly elastic demand. Now talking about your perfectly inelasticity of demand, you find that it is opposite of it. You find that we say there is no change in demand, but there is an infinite change, or there is a good amount of change in the price. So no matter price increase or decrease, the demand of that particular product remains constant. So there you find there is a vertical line which has been drawn and it is parallel to your y-axis. But in the previous case, if you see here in the perfectly elastic, it is parallel to your x-axis, where you find that no matter how much increase decrease in the demand has been there, you find that the price does not change. So you have to remember there is a elasticity, perfectly elastic, that is it parallel to your x-axis, and you find that your demand is infinite. When comes to perfectly inelastic, you find here there is a vertical line which is parallel to your y-axis and your price changes no matter what, but your demand does not changes. There the price does not changes. Now unitary means equal in the sense, that is, how much percentage change in the price, that much percentage change in demand is also there. So you find it, suppose there is a fall of 5% of price, then there is an increase of 5% in its demand. So you find that 5% divided by 5%, that is 1, and this is how you find that equilibrary, or we can say unitary elastic demand looks like all about. I hope you have been clear. Now coming to the relatively elastic demand, you find that there we know that it is greater than 1. So here you find that the percentage change in demand is more, proportionately more than the percentage change in price. So here there is a 30% change in demand due to 10% fall in price. So you find that, और यहाँ पे ऐसा लिखा है, इफ़ अ प्राइस ऑफ अ कमोडिटी राइजेस बाय 10%, मतलब प्राइस 10% से बढ़ गया तो उसका डिमांड 30% से कम हो गया. सो यू फाइंड दैट, सी हियर 10% प्राइस ओनली, दिस मच गैप इज बीन, वी फाइंड दैट इट इज बीन इंक्रीज, बट हियर यू फाइंड द डिमांड गैप इज मोर. सो देर इज अ डिक्रीज फ्रॉम M1 to M, दैट इज 30% चेंज इन डिमांड यू फाइंड. अगेन यू फाइंड रिलेटिवली इन इलास्टिक डिमांड, हियर इट इज ऑपोजिट ऑफ इलास्टिक डिमांड, वेयर वी फाइंड दैट देर इज अ न्यूमरस और हैवी चेंज इन प्राइस, बट द डिमांड ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट हैज डिक्रीज वेरी लेस. सो हियर वी फाइंड दैट प्राइस इंक्रीजेस बाई 20%, बट द डिमांड फॉल्स बाई 5%. So you find that 5% change in demand upon 20% change in price. So 5 upon 20, that is 1 upon 4, that is 0.5. So it is less than 1. Whereas in the previous case, it is more than 1, where we find it is greater than 1, that is 3 unit, because 30 divided by 10, 0 cut, 3 upon 1, 3. So here it is 3 and here it is 0.25. So you find that in elastic, it is always less than 1, and in elastic, it is more than one. Now coming to the two topics which are left, that is income elasticity of demand. Here there is not change due to price, but there is a change because of change in income of a consumer. So here you have to remember this, that income elasticity equals to proportionate change in demand upon proportionate change in income. Now what is happening up again, it has some of the decrease also, that is positive income elasticity demand, negative income elasticity demand, and third is zero income elasticity of demand. Now you find that here in positive income elasticity of demand, due to increase in income of a particular consumer, you find that there is a change in the particular demand. Ultimately agar aapka income badh raha hai to aapke father ka income badh raha hai to aapka वी कैन से डिमांड भी बढ़ेगा. अगर आपका पापा का इनकम कम हो गया ड्यू टू दिस पेंडेमिक सिचुएशन, फॉर एग्जाम्पल टेक इट लाइक दिस, सो यू फाइंड दैट सम ऑफ द गुड्स यू हैव कट शॉर्ट एंड यू हैव नॉट टेकन इन दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग. सो अल्टीमेटली वी कैन से देर इज़ अ पॉजिटिव रिलेशन बिटवीन द इनकम एज वेल एज द डिमांड ऑफ द गुड्स. अगर आपका पापा का इनकम बढ़ रहा है तो आप ज़्यादा गुड्स परचेज करोगे, आपका पापा का इनकम कम हो रहा है तो आप कम गुड्स परचेज करोगे. सो इट शोज अ पॉजिटिव रिलेशन बिटवीन द इनकम ऑफ योर फादर्स इनकम एंड वी फाइंड दैट डिमांड ऑफ द गुड्स. सेम वे इट इज़ ऑपोजिट अगेन अगेन देर आर थ्री मोर डिग्रीज विच यू फाइंड इन पॉजिटिव, दैट इज यूनिटरी, मोर देन वन एंड लेस देन वन. नाउ वॉट इज यूनिटरी, दैट इज इक्वल प्रोपोर्शनेट विच इज बिन हैपनिंग अप, दैट इज यूनिटरी. सो हियर यू फाइंड दैट कि अगर जितना प्रोपोर्शनल चेंज आपके इनकम में उतना ही चेंज आपका डिमांड में हुआ तो आपका वी कैन सी इट इज़ इक्वल टू वन. सपोज देर इज़ अ 10% इंक्रीज इन योर फादर्स इनकम एंड देर इज़ अ सेम वे यू फाइंड दैट 10% इंक्रीज इन योर डिमांड फॉर द गुड्स. सो 10/10 यू फाइंड दैट इट इज़ वन. सेम वे अगर देर इज more amount of increase in your father income, suppose 10% is your increase in demand for increase in income of your father, but your demand has increased only by 2%. So what is happening up? 10/2, it is more than 1, that is 5. Again same way, elasticity of demand less than unitary, मतलब कम हो जाएगा, तो यहाँ पर आपका father का income is 10%, but because there is an increase in 10% of your income, but you have demand for a goods which is 20%. So 10/20, now it becomes 1/2 and it becomes 0.5. So ultimately it is less than 1. So you have to remember, in positive things there are three things: unitary, that is equal to 1, greater than 1, that is more than 1, and you find that less than 1. So these are the three positive income elasticity of demand. Now moving to the negative income elasticity. Negative income elasticity kis mein aayega? When your income is increasing and you are moving from inferior goods to, we can say, नॉर्मल गुड्स, जैसे लेबरर्स है, वर्कर्स है जो कंस्ट्रक्शन में यहाँ पे काम करते हैं, तो वो लोग क्या खाते हैं, दे ट्राई टू ईट इन्फीरियर क्वालिटी ऑफ गुड्स, दैट इज़ बाजरा इज़ देयर, मेज़ इज़ देयर, चुआर इज़ देयर, सो ये सब चीज़ वो खाते हैं. सो अल्टीमेटली जब उन लोग का इनकम बढ़ जाएगा, दे विल मूव टू द नॉर्मल गुड्स एंड दे ट्राई टू कंज्यूम दैट पर्टिकुलर गुड्स, और वो जो इन्फीरियर क्वालिटी ऑफ गुड्स आते हैं वो उसको कम कर देंगे. अगर ऐसा नहीं कि यही इन्फीरियर क्वालिटी, दूसरी चीज़ में बोला जाए तो अगर सपोज द वीट विच वी आर ईटिंग, तो उसके अंदर भी इन्फीरियर क्वालिटी आती है जो कम पैसे में उन लोगों को राशन की दुकान में मिलता है. सो अल्टीमेटली दे ऑल्सो ट्राई टू परचेज दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग. सो अल्टीमेटली वॉट इज़ हैपनिंग, योर इनकम इंक्रीज हो रहा है तो आपने इन्फीरियर गुड्स छोड़ के कहाँ पे आ गए, नॉर्मल गुड्स पे. सो यू फाइंड दैट यू हैव लेफ्ट, सो नाउ यू आर डिमांडिंग लेस फॉर योर इन्फीरियर गुड्स, दैट्स वाई इट शोज अ नेगेटिव इम्पैक्ट एंड दैट्स वाई यू कैन सी इट इज़ अ नेगेटिव इनकम इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड विच इज़ बेन देयर. एंड यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट इज इन्फीरियर गुड्स एंड गिवन गुड्स विच कम्स अंडर नेगेटिव इनकम इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ गुड्स. नाउ देन कम्स द जीरो इनकम इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ गुड्स. वॉट इज हैपनिंग, नो मैटर हाउ मच चेंज इन योर डिमांड, वी कैन से इनकम इज देयर, देर इज नो चेंज इन योर डिमांड फॉर गुड्स. मतलब आपके फादर का इनकम बढ़ रहा है एवरी ईयर 10 years, लेकिन आपका डिमांड सेम ही है, कोई चेंज नहीं आ रहा, तो अल्टीमेटली वी कैन से दैट टाइम देर इज़ अ जीरो इनकम इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड विच इज़ बीन ऑब्जर्व्ड हियर. और नहीं तो यहाँ पे जैसे गुड्स लेना चाहे तो, फॉर एग्जांपल इनकम बढ़ रहा है, लेकिन आप ऐसा तो नहीं है कि एक मैच बॉक्स यूज़ कर रहे थे वो दो ला लोगे, एक स्टेपलर पिन यूज़ करे तो आप दूसरा बॉक्स ला लोगे. सो सम ऑफ द गुड्स, लो प्राइस गुड्स, वेयर यू फाइंड दैट द नो मैटर हाउ मच देर इज़ एन इंक्रीज इन डिमांड, यू फाइंड दैट ये आप ये सब प्रोडक्ट्स का डिमांड नहीं बढ़ेगा. दैट इज वी फाइंड दैट सॉल्ट इज़ देयर, पोस्ट कार्ड इज़ देयर, पिंस आर देयर, मैच बॉक्स आर देयर, स्टेपलर पिंस है, तो इन लोग का कुछ भी डिमांड इंक्रीज नहीं होगा अल्टीमेटली बिकॉज दे आर वेरी लो प्राइस गुड्स. नाउ मूविंग टू द वेरी लास्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज cross elasticity of demand. What is cross elasticity? You have to remember the supplementary goods and complementary goods here. So why? Because there are two products coming up. Suppose you find that your main product, यहाँ पे मैं एग्जाम्पल के साथ के आपको समझाता हूँ. योर मेन प्रोडक्ट इज बीन देयर, सेड इज फॉर एग्जाम्पल, सपोज लेट्स टेक टी एंड कॉफी. सो टी इज अ मेजर कंजप्शन इन इंडिया, यू फाइंड देन एंड देन आफ्टर सेकंड कंजप्शन कम्स अंडर दैट इज कॉफी. सपोज द कॉफी प्राइस रिड्यूसेज, यू फाइंड दैट द 20 रुपीज वन कॉफी इज बीन गिवन टू यू, इट इज द प्राइस ऑफ कॉफी इज 20 रुपीज एंड द प्राइस ऑफ टी हैज 10 रुपीज पर कप. Now what happens, suppose the price of coffee reduces 20 to 10, what happens? Now it has been equal. So what will happen? People will think like, if the price of coffee has reduced to 10 rupees, now I'm having an option with rupees 10, that either I want to go with, we can say tea, or either I can want to go with coffee. Then what is happening up? People thinks that coffee, which is a luxurious good or that main concern good, the price has reduced. People start taking that particular coffee more and more, and there is a reduction in the demand for tea. So what ultimately happened, that if a concerned product price falls, you find that there is a change in the demand for the other product. So here you have to remember that proportionate change in demand of X equals to upon proportionate change in the price of Y. So you find that this particular affects the demand. मतलब coffee के price कम होने के वजह से tea के demand के अंदर फ़र्क आया, उसको बोलेंगे क्रॉस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड. सो यू फाइंड दैट देयर द कंज्यूमर विल गो मोर टूवर्ड्स कॉफ़ी एंड टी का कंजप्शन जो कर रहे थे वही कम हो जाएगा. सो दिस इज़ व्हाट क्रॉस इलास्टिसिटी इज़ ऑल अबाउट. एंड लास्टली, अगर आपको इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड मेजर करना है, वो जो प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी, इनकम इलास्टिसिटी और क्रॉस इलास्टिसिटी, वो उसके टाइप्स हैं, ठीक है. बट इफ़ यू वॉन्ट टू मेजर, यू कैन गो विथ थ्री मैथड्स, दैट इज मैथड्स ऑफ प्रपोर्शनेट चेंज, टोटल एक्सपेंडिचर मेथड, नहीं तो उसको बोलेंगे टोटल आउटले मेथड, एंड लास्टली ज्योमेट्रिक मेथड. उसके अलावा भी दो और है मेथड्स, बट इट इज़ नॉट इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक. सो अल्टीमेटली यू हैव टू गो विद दिस थ्री मेथड्स, आइदर इट कैन कम फॉर वन और टू मार्क्स. सो आई होप यू हैव बीन क्लियर विद ऑल योर डाउट्स. इफ यू स्टिल फाइंड एनी डाउट, यू कैन जस्ट कॉल मैसेज मी रिगार्डिंग एंड ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. थैंक यू.